Abdul Rasheed Kehar, Assistant Professor, Subject English, Government Degree College, Madeji, District Shikarpur. My cell number is 0300-30-10585. My dear students, this is my third lecture about The Prisoner of Zenda, a novel prescribed on the intermediate level written by Mr. Anthony. In my first lecture, I discussed about novel and its elements. In the second lecture, the background of the title and the country of which we are reading this story. And I also discussed some major characters of the story. For example, number one major character, Rudolf Erfurth, 5. Number two, Black Michael, Duke of Stetson. Number three, Rudolf Rassendel, the hero of the story. Number four, Oliver Sacked. Number five, Princess Philibia. Number six, Rupert of Anza, a devil there of the story. And number seven, major role is of Madam Dima. She is a rich, beautiful widow of Paris. She is closely attached with the Duke of Stetson. She is in pursuit of marrying him, and she visits Stetson or Zenda frequently on the invitation of Black Michael. She plays a very important role in this story. Now, these are seven major roles of the novel. Minor roles, among minor roles, number one is Fritz. Fritz von Tollen is also in service of the King Rudolf Erfurth V, like Colonel Sapt. Number two, Countess Helga. She is in service of the Princess Philibia, the queen and beauty of the country, and she is also beloved of the face. Number three, Johan, a gamekeeper of Black Michael at Zenda. Number four, Mr. Robert, an Englishman, MP, member of parliament, elder brother of the hero, Rudolf Rassendel. He lives in Park Lane, London. Number five, Rose, wife of Mr. Robert, Lord Burlesdon. Mr. Robert, Lord Burlesdon. She acts as the wife of Lord Burlesdon. So this way, she performs the role of sister-in-law of the hero. Now, sixth is Marshal Strachness, Commander-in-Chief of the Ruritanian Army. My dear students, in the very first page of the first chapter of the novel, three characters are introduced to the readers. Number one is Rose, sister-in-law of Rudolf Rassendel. Rudolf Rassendel, the hero himself, is also introduced at the very first page of the first chapter of the story. And Lord Burlesdon, elder brother of Rudolf Rassendel. So these were important characters of the story. Now I am going to tell you some more important points about the story and the people of the novel. Now the whole story consisted of 22 chapters is narrated by the hero himself. Rodolfo Rosendell is narrating the whole story because he has used the pronoun I. He narrates the story. When he comes back after some months having performed the role of king, fifth king of the Ruritania, when he is back, he joins his family, then he starts narrating the story. He told the members of his family about his whereabouts and what he did during his absence from the family. So now this is the book, The Prisoner of Zenda. This is the introduction of the novel and its writer. And this is chapter 1. The title of the chapter 1 is The Rosendells with the Word on the Elf Box. Rosendells are of London and Elfbergs. Now this is the royal family that rules Ruritania. Now on this first page, now this is the first dialogue of Rose. Rose is talking to Rosendell. She says, "I wonder when in the world you are going to do anything, Rodolfo," said my brother's wife. So now this is a dialogue that almost we happen to hear in the families where jobless youth live. So Rodolfo Rosendell, no doubt, is a highly educated man. He has visited almost all of the continent, but till today he has not settled down himself to a formal profession or a formal job. This is why the family members are very much worried about his future. Now the first dialogue of Rose is telling us the anxiety, the uneasiness of the Rosendell family when she says, "I wonder when in the world you are going to do anything, Rodolfo," said my brother's wife. Now, in the response, Rodolfo Rosendell says, "My dear Rose," I answered, laying down my eggs. Now this is breakfast time and these two characters are sitting at the breakfast dining table. He says, "Why in the world should I do anything? Why should I do anything? My position is a comfortable one. I have an income nearly sufficient for my wants. No one's income is ever quite sufficient, no, you know." Now Rose shows her uneasiness for his being jobless, but in the response his attitude towards his sister-in-law is not positive. He is rather boasting. He wants to make her realize that he is a member of the Lord family. His brother, elder brother, is MP. He is an aristocratic family member. So he needs not to do anything because his income is more than his expenditure. But secretly, he just wants to take the readers into confidence. He says that, remember, no one's income is ever more than his expenditure. "I enjoy an enviable social position, I am brother to Lord Burlesdon and brother-in-law to that most charming lady, his countess. Behold, it is enough. So, in my opinion, this is not a satisfactory response or attitude of Rudolph Rassendyll to his rose as almost jobless youth. On the first part, they do not do anything. They do not take some solid steps to look for their jobs. And on the other hand, they feel like haughty people. They show themselves as a proud one. So this is an answer of the uneasiness of Rose. Now, she says, you are 29. Means you have seen 29 years of your age and you have done nothing but. Means she is trying to make Rudolph Rassendyll realize that you have completed your education. You have visited almost many countries and whole of the continent, but formally you are not settled down to any profession, or nor you have started any job, and just to maintain their social status in the society. Now, at this point, Rudolph Rassendyll likes to give up the topic and he says, not about. It is true, our family doesn't need to do things. This dialogue of Rudolph Rassendyll again is not pleasant one. Now this angers Rose. Our family doesn't need to do things. Now this dialogue of Rudolph Rassendyll is aimed at showing the family of Rose inferior to that family which Rudolph Rassendyll himself belongs. This is an irritating dialogue uttered by Rudolph Rassendyll. So this remark of my brother annoyed Rose. Naturally, everybody gets irritated if the response from any member of the family comes in disfavor. For everybody knows, and therefore there can be no harm in referring to the fact that pretty and accomplished as he herself is, her family is hardly the same standing as the Rassendylls. So his motto and his point clearly comes out that he wants to show Rose inferior to that of his family. Besides her attractions, she possessed a large fortune, and my brother Robert was wise enough not to mind about her ancestry. So this way, one point more that Rudolph Rassendyll likes to show that he wants to realize his sister-in-law, that she is fortunate in the sense that his brother got married with her. Again, this attitude also causes the anger of the Rose. So, I read some dialogues from the first chapter just to inform my students that this whole of the story of about 22 chapters is narrated by the hero himself. Now I am going to tell that, as I earlier told you, that Mr. Rudolph Rassendyll is an Englishman it belongs to London. And Ruritania is ruled by the Elfberg family. Then the question is, how does he become the ruler of the king? What is the reason? What is the fact behind this? So the fact is that fate brings to Rudolf Rasendel to Zenda. And the fact is that there is close resemblance of figure, of personality between Rudolf Elfberg 5 and Rudolf Elfberg 4. Now, red hair and long nose, these are two personality characters of the Elfberg family. Every member of the Elfberg family has long hair, has long nose and red hair. And so of Rudolf Rasendel, though he is an Englishman, he belongs to Rasendel family. So actually what happens that there was a love affair between a lady, a girl of the Rasendel family and king of Elfberg family of Ruritania. There was a scandal, and through that scandal there appear biologically, medically, two characters, two features of having red hair and long hair and long nose of Elfberg family to Rasendel family. So whenever any child was born in Rasendel family, he had either red hair or long nose. But Rudolf Rasendel is the boy who has got both of the characteristics of the Elfberg family. When he was born, he had red hair and he had also long nose. So this close similarity between Rudolf Elfberg 5 and Rudolf Rasendel gives us the story. Otherwise, how can an Englishman become the ruler of Ruritania when a stepbrother of the king cannot be the ruler according to the law of the country? Now, this close similarity of having red hair and long nose gives us the story and causes to be the king of Ruritania. Rudolf Rasendel reaches Zenda, and there he happens to be persuaded by Sept and Fates to impersonate as the king, because real king, I told in my earlier lecture, that he is to be crowned very shortly, but still he has not crowned. So Rudolf Elfberg 5, on the invitation of Black Michael, has come from Strelsa 2 days before his coronation ceremony, Rasmi Tarkushi. 2 days before his coronation ceremony to Zenda. Now at Zenda, he takes too much wine, drugged wine, given by Joseph on the order of Black Michael, and when he takes too much drugged wine in the shooting lodge of the castle of Zenda on the other morning, when he was bound to leave for Strelsa from Zenda to Zenda, he falls unconscious. And luckily, when Rudolf Rasendel leaves London, he comes to Paris. From Paris, he comes to Zenda by train. And in that same train, Madame de Maupin is traveling on the invitation of Black Michael to go to Asst's art to witness the coronation ceremony of 12th February. Now he happens to meet at Zenda. He happens to meet in the forest of Zenda with the real king, and real king knows the close relationship with the Rudolf Rasendel, because I already told you that when two persons having same characteristics like red hair and sharp nose, long nose, when they meet in the forest of Zenda, now Rudolf from Elfberg remembers the story and he calls Rudolf Rasendel his cousin, and he takes him to castle of Zenda where he is staying on the invitation of Lake Michael. So after having dinner, they together take huge amount of wine, especially a full bottle of drugged wine, which is the conspiracy of Lake Michael. Rudolf Elfberg V, before becoming the king formally, falls unconscious on the very morning of his coronation ceremony in Strelitza. Then sat and fails who are with Rudolf Elfberg in the castle of Zenda. They are very much sorrowful, and they are very much anxious, and they are very much uneasy when they are sure that Rudolf Elfberg is not in a position to come to senses, and he cannot be taken to Strelitza for his coronation. They persuade Rudolf Rasendel to shave off his moustaches and beard, and to act as the fifth king of the ruling Britannia, because they know and they see that their personality is almost same, and no one can differentiate between Rudolf Elfberg V and Rudolf Rasendel. Firstly, Rudolf Rasendel does not agree with them to take such a high risk to be the king of any country, but on their request, and when Colonel Sapp discloses that Black Michael, the enemy of Rudolf Elfberg and Princess Philippia, and also the throne and crown of the Elfberg family, now looking at the dire consequences of the Elfberg family, lastly, Rudolf Rasendel agrees with Colonel Sapt, and he goes by train with Sapt and Fitz to Strelitza, where he takes an oath as the fifth king of Britannia, and he performs all the formal activities that are carried out in the ceremony. So it was all possible because Rudolf Rasendel has the same personality as Rudolf Elfberg has. He has red hair like him, he has sharp nose like him, and earlier I told my students that he has also no language problem. That because though Rudolf Rasendel is an Englishman by birth, but he also knows French and German very well. Language of Ruritanian, this is a point to be noted, language of Ruritanians is German, and he could speak very easily. Even he was so successful to be acting as the king, fifth king of Ruritania, then wrote that Princess Philippia, who is the queen and beauty of the country, who is to marry the king after his coronation, is not in a doubt that the person whom she is dancing, the person whom she is having lunch or dinner or whatsoever she is performing, all the formal activities, has no doubt as to whether he is Rudolf Rasendel or Rudolf Elfberg. So it was a successful ceremony that Rudolf Rasheed performed, and he continued from that day as the king of Ruritania. So inshallah, I'll carry on this lecture and I'll tell my students in my next lecture what happens next. Thank you.